Assalamu alaikum brothers and sisters in Islam. Today we have come up with another video and we'll be discussing the Surah Al-Naba which was revealed in Makkah. In the name of Allah, the most gracious, the most merciful. What are they asking about? About the great news, about which they are in disagreement. Nay, they will come to know. Nay, again, they will come to know. Have we not made the earth as a bed and the mountains as pegs? And we have created you in pairs, and we have made your sleep as a thing for rest. And we have made the night as a covering, and we have made the day for livelihood. And we have built above you seven strong, and we have made therein a shining lamp. And we have sent down from the Muassirat waters Tajjaj, that we may produce therewith grains and vegetations and gardens that are alfaf. So friends, this was the recitation of Surah Al-Naba from the verse 1st to verse 16. And what is Allah trying to say through these verses? These verses are actually refutation against the idolaters' denial of occurrence of the Day of Judgment. So in rejection to the idolaters about the Day of Judgment, or due to their denial of its occurrence, Allah says, what are they asking about the great news? Which means that they are asking about the matter of Day of Judgment, and it is indeed a great news. The great news here means that it is dreadful, horrifying, overwhelming information. So about which they are in disagreement, and pertaining to this verse, there are people divided into two different ideas. One is those who believe in the Day of Judgment, and the others who deny or disbelieve in the Day of Judgment. So Allah threatens those who deny the Day of Judgment by saying, nay, they will come to know. Nay, again, they will come to know. This is a severe threat and a direct warning from Allah the Supreme. Mentioning Allah's power and the proof of His ability to resurrect the dead, then Allah begins to explain His great abilities to create strange things and amazing matters. He brings all of this as a proof of His ability to do whatever He wishes concerning the matter of the hereafter and other matters as well. So Allah says, have we not made the earth as a bed? So as a bed, earth is an established, firm and peaceful resting place that is subservient to them. Then Allah says, and we have created mountains as pegs. That mountains have been made as pegs for earth to hold it in place so that it doesn't sway with the people moving on it, so that it becomes stable and firm. This is so that it may be suitable for dwelling and not quack with those who are in it. Then Allah says, and we have created you in pairs, which means that male and female, both of them enjoying each other, and by this, which means is procreation is achieved. So this is similar to Allah's statement when He says, among His signs is that He created for you wives from among yourselves, that you may find repose in them, and He has put between you affection and mercy. This ayah is from Surah 30, ayat number 21. Allah further says, and we have made your sleep as a thing for rest. That is, it is a cessation of movement in order to attain rest from the frequent repetition and going about in search of livelihood during the daytime. So a similar ayah has been mentioned previously in Surah Al-Furqan, where Allah says, and we have made the night as a covering, which means that its shade and darkness covers the people. Then Allah says, by the night as it conceals it, concerning Allah's statement, and we have made the day for livelihood, which means we made it radiant, luminous and shining so that people would be able to move about in it, but they are able to come and go for their livelihood, earning business dealings and other than that as well. So in reference to this Allah's statement, and we have built above you seven strong. So by seven strong, Allah means the seven heavens one upon each other. So the seven heavens in their vastness, loftiness, perfection, precision and adornment with both stable and moving star. Thus Allah says, and we have made therein a shining lamp, which pertains to the radiant sun that gives light to all of the world. It glows for all the people of the earth. Allah then says, and we have sent down from Muassirat water sajjaj. So Muassirat means from the clouds. And it was said by Al-Farra that they are the clouds that are filled with rain, but they do not bring rain. And Al-Sajjaj means the poured out. Then Allah further says that you may produce therewith corns and vegetations and gardens that are al-paf, so that we may bring out great abundance, goodness, benefit and blessings through this water. By the garden al-faf, Allah means gardens of various fruits, differing colors and wide variety of tastes and fragrance, even if it is ingathered at one location of the earth. So this is similar to Allah's statement in Surah 13, ayah number 4, that Allah says, and in the earth are neighboring tracts and gardens of vines and green crops and date palms, growing into two or three from a single stem root or otherwise, watered with the same water, yet some of them we make more excellent than others to wait. Verily, in these things there are ayah for the people who understand. So with this, we come to the end of our first part of Surah Al-Naba. We shall discuss the other part of Surah Al-Naba in our upcoming videos. So until we meet next, Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.